Hello everyone, welcome all of you for the Building Material Testing Laboratory video lecture. Today we are going to discuss about the experiment shear test. In that we are having two cases, one is single shear and second one is double shear. So first aim of the experiment is to determine the ultimate shear strength of the given specimen in single shear and double shear. And apparatus required, we are using the specimen and universal testing machine and the shear shackle and vernier caliper for measurement of the diameter. Now I will move on to the concept of shear stress. What do you mean by shear stress? So if we are having a beam, if it is subjected to load, we are having a resistance parallel to the cross sectional area. The shear stress is similar to the normal stress. In the normal stress, the resistance is perpendicular to the cross sectional area, but in shear stress, the resistance is parallel to the cross sectional area. So this we can call it as shear stress, and which is denoted by the symbol tau. Tau is given by the resistance force divided by cross sectional area. The force unit is Newton, and area is given by meter square. The unit of shear stress is Newton per meter square, or we can call it as Pascal. 1 Pascal is nothing but 1 Newton per meter square. Now I will move on to the difference between a single shear and double shear. What do you mean by single shear then? So if I have a specimen, if it is subjected to load, then only one cross sectional area is resisting the failure. So that material is in single shear. The same thing here. We are having only one resistance, one cross sectional area resisting the force. So this we can call it as the single shear. So the shear strength is given by force by area P by A. And we are having the same specimen. Now it is subjected to the shear force, but it is resisted by two cross sectional area. So here we are having the resistance is P by 2, and here we are having a P by 2. So two cross sectional area we have. So if it is two cross sectional area, then the material is subjected to double shear. The shear strength of double shear is given by P by 2A. So because we are having two cross sectional area. Now I will move on to the first case, that is a single shear. Single shear test, we are using the material aluminium. For that we are having an apparatus, call it as shear shackle. In that we are having shear box, shear plate, and two shear dies, and we are having the specimen. Now first measure the diameter of the specimen by using a vernier caliper, and note on that reading in your observation book. After that, place the shear die in the shear plate and properly fix it in the shear box. After placing the shear plate in the shear box, place the specimen within that, and another die is placed on one side of the shear box, and opposite to that one will be free. Only one side we have placed the shear die. This is because the test is single shear. After placing that one, the entire box should be placed between the middle cross head and lower table, and on the instrument close both the walls, and press down button of the cross head to lower the middle cross head up to touch the box. Then tear the load and reset the displacement on the instrument, and tear the load. After that, release the right wall. Now the entire system is subjected to load. Now the load is acting on it. The load is also increasing with respect to the displacement. Here the load is reaching the maximum value, and it will suddenly drop. So aluminium is a ductile material. Yeah, we can observe the failure of the specimen with single shear. After that, off the instrument, release the left valve, and take out the specimen out. So this will be the failure of the specimen with the single shear. So we got the failure in one cross section. The resistance is one cross sectional area. That's why it is the single shear. Single shear test. The specimen after the failure, it will be look like this. Then the observation and calculations. Here in this for single shear, we measure the diameter of the specimen by vernier caliper. I got it as 12 mm. Then area of the cross section is given by pi d square by 4. I got it as 113.04 mm square. Then if I make a tabulation over here like this, so area we are having, the diameter I have. Then if you know the maximum load at the failure, it is reached in the loading unit. It has taken maximum load, it has 33.6 kilonewton. From the UTM I got this result. So it is in terms of kilonewton. In terms of newton, nothing but we need to multiply it by 10 raised to 3. I got it as 33.6 into 10 raised to 3 newton. And we know that ultimate shear strength is given by tau is equal to load by ultimate load divided by cross sectional area. We have the ultimate cross sectional area in terms of newton, and area I have in terms of millimeter square. So the value will be 297.23 mm newton per mm square. So if I have the factor of safety 3, then divide by 3. So this value divided by 3, I got the value as 99.07 newton per mm square. This will be the safe shear strength of the aluminium. Remaining value will be for factor of safety purpose. So this is regarding a single shear. Now I will move on to the double shear test. Same procedure, but we are having three dies here. Same shear box, shear place with three dies. The material is aluminium only. Same procedure. So place the shear die in the shear plate and place it properly in the shear box and place the specimen. Now place both the dies, close it in both the direction. So it will be placed in both the direction. So we are using totally three dies in a double shear, but in a single shear it is only two dies. Now place the specimen, entire unit in the UTM machine, and close both the valve down the cross head. The middle cross head will touches the specimen. Then on the instrument and tear the load and reset the displacement. Then gradually release the right valve. Now the load is starts applying on the entire specimen. It is starts resisting the load. The load will be changes with respect to the displacement. Okay, it is reaching the maximum value. After reaching the maximum value, the load will be going downward. It's a ductile material. It is reaches the maximum value. And now we can observe the failure of the specimen. So here, yeah, suddenly the drop of the material means the material is failed. Release the left valve and take out the specimen outside from the UTM machine. Then if I remove the specimen from the box, we will get the failure of the specimen with two shear resistance. Means we are having three pieces of our specimen. This shows that the material is subjected to double shear. Okay, this will be the double shear test specimen after the failure. Now observation and calculations for double shear. The same specimen I am using. Here it is also the 12 mm diameter. Area is 113.04 mm square only. Now the tabulation, here we are having the diameter, cross sectional area same, but it has taken the maximum load 56.8 kilonewton. In terms of newton, it is 10 raised to 3. So then this load divided by the cross sectional area, I got the ultimate shear strength is 251.23 newton per mm square. So factor of safety is 3 we are using. So then safe shear strength, so up to that extent we can use it for design. So safe shear is 83.74 for double shear. So the final results, so from the data I got, it has for single shear, ultimate shear strength is given by 293.23. and safe shear strength is 99.07 newton per mm square. For in double shear it is 251.23 newton per mm square, and safe shear strength I got it as 83.74 newton per mm square. So this will be the end of the experiment. Thank you one and all.